Right, so I've just been invited to the home of a world-renowned, famous sculptor. And I'm very excited today because we're going to do a project, my very first project. He's going to show me how to do this. So his name is Alejandre Verte. I think he's Spanish or Italian or something. So here we're coming up to his home right now. Let's go say good morning to Mr. Verte. Hello. No sign. Alejandre. Señor Verte. Hello, is this the home of the famous sculptor?
Yeah.
Awesome. Woohoo. He's going to explain what we're doing.
Hello. We are going to make a relief. Leroy's going to make a heart-shaped relief out of clay, first of all, and we're going to go through the process of how to make it into a solid plaster relief.
That's good.
So we have got one bit of lino, one board. Lino goes in the board. Terracotta clay, or any modelling clay you have. Rolling tool, wooden cutting tool, and we're going to start off with rolling this out and making a bit of clay, which is like a pad, a thin kind of pad of clay, which we can model and make the heart shape from. So first of all, that's what we're going to do, that's stage one. Okay,
so I've just rolled out the clay and cut a square that fits this size. And then
we're going to use this as a clay slip, and it's water mixed with clay. See, it's like a brown substance. We're going to paint it off to our lino just to give it that dividing layer.
Okay, my idea is a bit cliche. It's the shape of a heart, cross in the middle, and I'm rolling out little spaghetti snakes. And the plan is to line these snakes inside the heart to make little paths, kind of like a maze thing. That's the plan.
All right, so this is what I've made. Not there. And we'll see how we get on. Heart, the little spaghetti maze.
So here we're going to make a waste mold, and we're going to use gouache, glue, mixed into this with water, fine casting plaster.
Zoom in for the action. Whoa, here we go. My hand is supposed to help set, or how does it work?
Yeah, the heat's going to help speed up the setting process.
Yeah, setting process.
So we've just got the plaster, the gouache, and the water, and then once it starts going off, we're going to start putting it on here. So here we have the plaster going off. We've got the clay wall, the fence around the outside, and it's getting slightly thicker, so we're going to start putting it on in very small amounts, building it up in layers to cover the clay up to build our waste mold.
It's also very exciting. There we have our waste mold. We're going to let it set for
20 minutes.
Okay, here we are at the next stage. We have the waste mold, and we're going to take off the clay wall or fence. And we're going to pop that to the side. And we can clean that later. Then we're going to slowly turn this upside down. Remove the lino.
Ta-da, chocolate cake.
And what that reveals, yeah, if we just lay it down now.
Yes, I do, like so.
So then therefore we have now the clay. And we are going to take the clay out now.
With what?
We're going to grab one of these.
Yep. Keep the camera. Grab one of these.
Yeah. I'm going to see if it's going to come out easily. It might not, it might take a little bit of time. You might find a place where you can prise it out as a wanna.
Right, right, right.
Maybe from a corner somewhere. It might just come out as one big slab, hopefully.
Is this going to dig in? Do I have to be careful?
Maybe. Clay is quite soft.
Yeah, I think I'm digging into the clay.
Okay.
Right, so we took the clay backing off, and now we've got clay left in the grooves, which I've got to remove. We've already taken the centerpiece out, so I've got to take out all this clay. So, dug out clay from all these channels. Few more to go. And having fun. Giving it just a quick clean.
Hello, we have come to this stage. Our waste mold is being made. We've cleaned out the clay. We've smoothed the edges off. We've dried it out. And now we're going to experiment with using clear varnish shellac. So I'm going to use some shellac and I'm going to paint it onto the surface here. This is hopefully going to help us creating a boundary, a layer, a slip. So this is this waste mold will break off against the other plaster, which we're going to pour into it.
Right.
And Vaseline time.
Boom. Boom. Right, now we're putting on a wall to contain all the plaster we pour inside. Final plaster mix! Ba-ba-ba-bum!
Okay, finally we've got the Vaseline on, the shellac on, the Vaseline on, clay wall, and we're pouring into the last waste mold.
Too small.
No, that's good. And we've made a very strong plaster mix, just fine casting plaster. And we're filling up all the gaps. I'm going to take it halfway up the clay wall, roughly.
That's the wire to hang it on the wall with. And we'll remove the coat wire later. And now we're going to let that sit for about half an hour or so and harden. And then chip away the parts we're allowed to chip away. Woohoo! Exciting! We're knocking away the doorway mold.
Yeah, this is the mold.
Be careful not to wreck what's underneath. Progress, nearly there. So here we have Mr. Brown's final piece of artwork. First time I've ever done any, what is this, plaster?
Casting.
There it is, heart, spaghetti maze across the middle, little hook on the back to hang. Very foresightful. Very pleased, had a lot of fun, really enjoyed myself. And now I could paint it, some paints and stuff like that. Thank you. a heck of a lot of work. Brilliant paint job by Mr. Brown. And yeah, so all that remains is to go home and find that special place on that special wall and hang it up. Many thanks to Alejandre Verte for his master tutoring. I'm going home now. Bye-bye.